A car is moving towards a stationary wall with 20 meter per second. If it whistles with a frequency 124 Hz, calculate the number of beats produced per second. Velocity of sound in air V is 330 meter per second. Here the car is moving towards the stationary wall and the person sitting inside the car observes the reflected or echo also. So you can hear the direct sound as well as the echo. The difference between them must produce beats. So let us consider a source that is a car moving towards the wall with a speed u. Let n is the frequency of the sound emitted by the source. As the source is moving towards the wall, the apparent frequency on the wall is n1, let us say. So equation for n1, n into, here source is in motion and observer is at rest, v minus u, take it as equation 1. Now from the wall the same frequency gets reflected, but now this is moving towards the source which is in motion. Therefore the frequency as observed by the person inside the car, let it be n2. Here wall is acting like the source and the person is observer inside the car. Now n2 becomes equal to n1 into observer moving towards the source, v plus u by v. Or if I substitute n1 from the first equation, v by v minus u into v plus u by v, v and v gets cancelled, so it is v plus u by v minus u. Now the difference between the n2 and n, that must be responsible for beats. So delta n is equal to n2 minus n. Therefore n into v plus u by v minus u minus n. So n if I take out and LCM v minus u, then it is v plus u minus v plus u. So I can cancel the term v. The remaining if I write, so delta n is equal to n into 2u by v minus u, or this can be written as delta n by 2n is equal to u by v minus u, where delta n is the beats, beat frequency, u is the velocity of the source moving towards the hill, and n is the actual frequency. If the same source moves away from the hill, say with a speed v, then the delta n by 2n becomes equal to u by v plus u. Now in the present case, substitute the values. Delta n by 2 into frequency of sound is 124 and velocity 20 and 330. Delta n by 124 is equal to 20 divided by 330 minus 20. Now let us simplify this one. So delta n by 2 into 124 is equal to 20 by 310. So I can cancel this 0 and this 0. Now 31, exactly 4 times. So we can write delta n as 2 into 4, 8, 8 into 16. So beat frequency is 16, but the person cannot hear these beats, because if the beat frequency is greater than 10, impossible to hear. So there is a difference in frequency of 16 Hz, but the person cannot hear any beats, so he will hear it as a single sound. So beat frequency becomes 0.